you have your cause, but don't touch my elephant. You
the
can,
only one
you know,
best for life.
This is the best, look.
Last year, photographer John Chua was among those who defended the Manila Zoo amid calls for its closure by animal rights advocates.
Okay, raise the flag.
Chua is not afraid to take up unpopular and challenging causes.
Unlawful breath.
Just like his involvement in photography with a difference, taking care of Mali the elephant began by accident 12 years ago.
So how did that come about?
My daughter wants to volunteer for the zoo, right? So very young, said, Papa, I would like to volunteer. So she went there on her own. And I guess volunteerism in our country is not that well received, right? So she one day crying, came home crying, said, I don't do anything there. They don't allow us to do anything, right? Okay, I go and talk to them. So I talked to the director. I said, look, guys, these are young people. You're not paying them, right? But they want to help. Why don't you just give them a chance, right? I said, okay. So what I did as a father, I said, okay, I'll support you. So I go there. At the beginning, I was just there to support my daughter. Okay. Then I begin to learn about about all the animals there. Then you get to get involved in their activity. And then one day I said to the zookeeper when we were having a meeting, instead of just throwing the food, why don't you learn more about the animals that you care? And then you probably will have a better way of doing your job. As usual, they said, ah, sandaling sabihin yan, mahirap gawin yan, right? So I said, okay, I'll prove it to you that it can be done. So I said, I'll do it. I'll show you I can do it. Then I look at the elephant. I talk to her. Her eye sparkles.
Really?
She's listening, right? So I said, okay, start reading about elephant. Then I begin to get close to her. Then the zookeeper assigned to her suddenly got another job, right? So I'm left alone with her, right? Then there's a new zookeeper and starts getting close to me. I'm the only one now that she listens, and I'm the only one that she allows me to be close to her.
Really?
Or else she runs after everybody. I'm saying, you know, she hates everybody except me. So my wife gets a little bit jealous, right? I'm saying, I got this 37-year-old, right? Right? Nice eyelashes, big eyes, right? Right? Sexy 4-ton elephant.
But it's not always been easy looking after an elephant. She has her tantrums. But for John, it's a lifetime commitment. Mali has also been a great source of inspiration for his pursuits in photography. John Key Chua Jr. was born January 21, 1948 to John Chua and Daisy Key. He confesses to being a bum in his younger days until he discovered photography 39 years ago.
You said you call yourself a late bloomer.
Yes, I was a bummer.
Meaning you were just bumming around?
Yeah, I was just bumming around. So it took me, 25? When I was 25, then I figured I need to start somewhere. So I stole the camera of my brother-in-law and found out that I have an eye for photography. So that started it. But that time there was no seminars, no workshop. A very few books, so you had to do it by trial and error, so which I think is good because you spend a lot of time testing, but once you finally get the right thing, it stays for you forever because of the hardship of learning this technique.
Because you developed, you studied on your own.
Yes.
Your
self-taught. Yes, self-taught. Yes.
Chua became a photojournalist for Asia Week for a few years, which further honed his skills and entered into advertising when his fiancé, Harvey Valentino, gave him an ultimatum.
I was courting my wife then. Said, you know, either you give it up or we make it into a business. So she she said, okay, you shoot and I manage. So she goes around and offer my service and show my stuff. And what I do is I just shoot.
The Chua couple invested in the best camera and lighting equipment and established Ad Photo, which is considered a pioneer in commercial photography and one of the first to embrace digital technology. Ad Photo has participated in ad campaigns of almost every product on store shelves and is considered the agency of choice of car manufacturers.
You see, we take this, we clear this out, right? I would rather shoot product than talents. The talents, you need to make them feel good. You need to beat a little flirt and all that. The product, no. It stays there, and then, you know, you don't talk to them, right? You light them up, right? And then you find that I shoot cars. It's a product, right? But I shoot
inanimate, no?
But I show you cars. I love shooting cars because it gives you that curves. If you're looking at the curves in the female form, you know, I see curves, and I put the lights where this thing comes out alive. You know, my role is to make the public wants to buy that car, right? And it doesn't talk. I just have to show it.
Chua is also an expert in aerial photography. And after almost four decades, the passion for taking pictures still runs in John's veins.
I never work in a day because I enjoy what I'm doing. And last night I felt bad because I had to see my doctor. And I was always looking forward to that secretary. And the doctor said, oh, he just retired because he's 60. I said, do people have to retire? I'm 64, right? And I'm dreaming a lot of things yet to do, right?
At many instances in his career, John would prove the power of a photograph in changing the way things are done.
It's always start with a challenge. Okay, every photographer knows you go to Arhidalgo because that's where everything is there and the cheapest. I'm saying if you go to the mall, you pay for the, you know, but you want something unique, something cheap, you go to Arhidalgo. So every time I go there, I have to go through all these stalls, right? All this, you know, muddy and all that, right? And you couldn't even find the shop, right? So one day I was going through that and said, I talked to the owner, I said, look, guy, why don't you have something, do something to take these people out?
It's like a slum area?
It's like a slum area. I'm saying the whole street is covered with change. I'm saying you don't even see the shop anymore. Right in the gate of that store, small store, you still have somebody there on a, you know, nakaupo, and they sleep and eat, whatever. They do the thing right there. I'm saying it's really crazy. So I told them, can you do anything about John, 30 years. We can do it. You wanna do it? Sabita kita ng medalya, right?
Okay.
Sabi ko, okay. Prepare that medalya, right? So next day, with my small camera, I start taking pictures. Then I start talking to each owner. I said, look, what if we get together, right? You form a group, right? And I'll work it out. Said it can't be done.
So an association was formed among the owners.
No association first. I said let's meet. So I asked for a meeting that's closed. Everybody came, but you know, nobody was talking to each one because it's very tense competition. They kill each other.
They're rivals.
Yeah, they're all rivals. They don't talk to each other, right? So they came in. Everybody went. At least everybody came, right?
Chua set up a meeting with then-Mayor Atienza with the aim of cleaning up the area, but he became the target of attacks.
Of course, you have the vendors who's been there for all the 25 years, all of a sudden they're out of place, right? So I really received calls, and then they said, who's this guy? Who's John Chua? He's not even from Manila.
To get things done quickly, Chua chose a place to relocate the vendors.
So where was the place?
First, they have to clear it. Okay, once they clear it, then they have to cement it. And then we had the one beautiful inauguration. I'm saying, all the shops, put up their signs, they clean it up and all that. So
business boomed.
Yeah, in a sense, yes.
Eh, napaka-importante ni John dahil siya yung, kumbaga, ano, siya yung nag-spearhead sa amin, siya yung namuno sa amin para magka-isa kami. Siyempre, magkakalaban kayo. Sa pamamagitan ni John, siya yung nakipag-usap sa mga tindahan na ano. Anyway, mga kaibigan niya rin naman yung mga yan. Kaya, ayun, nabuo yun.
They should have rewarded you with free...
No. You know...
But did you get your medal?
No, not yet, you know, because they form a group, right? And they want me to be the president. I said, no, that's too much. I think I've done this, and I will move on, right? And for me, when I do things, I do it, and when it's good, then I move on. I don't want to stay forever.
And most recently, Chua embarked on another cause when he revisited the rice terraces and saw its sorry state.
So, after 25 years, I haven't been to Batad. I said, okay, I'll go there. So I went there and saw this damage right in the center of the village. So I said, I take pictures of them. While I was taking pictures, then I see this young man behind me chewing betel nut, nganga. I said, are you part of the owner of the family that owns this? Yes, sir. So what are we going to do about it? Oh, we're waiting for the funds. It would cost 10 million pesos to repair. I look at him. How do you know? It cost 10 million to repair that. I'm saying, if you compute it, yung ani nun, hindi pa abot ng 10 million, right? What's wrong, right? So I took pictures and I felt bad because I know these people. They're very proud.
Once again, Chua would prove the power of a photograph. Next, on People.
I do not promise you fun, but if we work together, we'll let the people of Batad start it. We'll have people from the lowland coming in to help you.